And many people would say that actually nicotine and caffeine are very similar molecules. Could you please discuss that statement and maybe say in your own words what their similarities are?
There are similarities. If we go back 30, 40 years ago, both were cultural drugs. Tobacco was used by at least among men, 50-60% in some countries. So these were the top used cultural drugs. The similarities is also that they do not have any psychotoxicity, caffeine and nicotine, which most other drugs do have, cannabis for example. The similarity was they were also accepted in all cultures, all countries, virtually all religions, like Coca-Cola, which is interesting, that has also gone through the world, every country, every sort of culture and religion, and that's of course because it's something more than soda. There is a drug there laced with sugar. Both had some benefits to the users, usually of a cognitive art, and both had small adverse effects. That's why I think they could thrive and be so prevalent and used so often.
And it's interesting that in society, caffeine is so widely accepted and consumed on a daily basis. So why do you think caffeine is so widely accepted and nicotine is so unaccepted?
I think, as I said, there was not much difference between tobacco use and caffeine use up until a certain time. And what happened then was that tobacco industry behaved very poorly, very badly, and got a reputation that aroused hatred for many, not only users, but population at large, regulators. Another thing is that nicotine, as has been pointed out by Dr. Farsalinos, thrived in a very toxic environment, usually the cigarette, while caffeine was not in such a toxic environment at all. Passive smoking came up as one thing that was a very untoward for cigarettes. And another thing now, when we do see nicotine in in absolute pure form, like in the white pouches, that is that caffeine comes in coffee, grained coffee beans. They are brown and you put in many spoons to get a cup of coffee. The pure nicotine comes in white powder and you need a few milligrams. And white powder is also something that cocaine comes into, morphine, etc. And I think this arouses connotations and a kind of resistance in the population. So these are some of the differences.
Thank you very much.
What Carl is mentioning is reasons to explain, but not to justify the misperceptions. These reasons are not good enough to justify those kind of misperceptions. In fact, all these reasons are purely non-scientific. They have nothing to do with real evidence, and they have nothing to do with the real effects of nicotine. Unlike cocaine, heroin, and other opioids that we very frequently see that these are compared with nicotine, and they appear in the same cell in a table discussing about addictiveness and addictive substances. Unlike those chemicals, nicotine is perfectly compatible with social and daily activities, because it is a cognitive enhancer, unlike all other substances, including marijuana, THC, which has now been considered a pure substance that can be used recreationally by the whole population. Many governments are, one after the other, legalizing the recreational use of marijuana. Marijuana does not improve cognition. In fact, it depresses cognition, and other opioids, of course, do it in a much worse way, and they are not compatible with daily social activities. nicotine is perfectly compatible. You can have normal, if not improved, personal life, family life, social life, professional life, while using nicotine in the same way, and that's another resemblance, in the same way when you use caffeine. So nicotine is more similar to caffeine than it is to opioid drugs that we very frequently see nicotine being compared to. It has nothing to do with opiates. Opiates do not improve. In fact, they depress cognition. They have other very adverse effects, and they are not compatible with daily life, social life, and activities. So there shouldn't be any discussion comparing nicotine with opioids. We should be comparing it with caffeine, with the exception of tobacco cigarettes, of course. But again, and that's my message, Carl mentioned several reasons to explain, but not to justify the misperceptions that exist in society, within the public health community, and within the regulatory authorities.
May I throw in the torch here, 10 seconds?
Course. Yeah.
It's interesting in the US, if you look at the prevalence of tobacco use, it's ticking down year by year. If you look at the prevalence of cannabis use, it's ticking up year by year. And it looks to be two very good communicating yards. Is that good for public health?